All right, what is up? Welcome to part four of the RISC-V and RARS series. There were a couple corrections in the part three video that I put in the comments. Mainly, the code for printing starts at one. The zero code is not valid. I'm not sure why this source led me to believe that it was. Maybe this is just for the visual simulator. Perhaps it has a different set of instructions. And the instructions, it's fully open source, so the instructions will vary, or can vary, in theory. Also, if you put in a non-integer for the read instruction, it will also throw an error as well. So there is some kind of error checking. The value has to be greater than 2, as it says here, or else it will just pass in whatever is in the X10 register. So that's about it. You got to use the proper type, you got to use the proper code, and you got to make sure that the values you enter are correct. Only entering the incorrect type will throw an error though. So let's step through this bad boy. All right, so we got three sections here we're going to be looking at. I've already explained the text segment and the register segment, and I have already apologized for the small text size. There's nothing we can do about that, unfortunately. But our main focus today is looking at this data segment, which contains all the information, all the memory information related to the assembler directive. And in this case, we only have two assembler directives, the data section and the text section, that are viewable here. Technically, we have the ASCII Z sections, but those are included inside of the data assembler directive. So you will see them here. We're now in the data segment, and to confirm, you can look at the ASCII, which is kind of the human readable, and we can see that we have the S and the equals, the N and the equals, and the new line here. We can look at the hexadecimal codes and confirm that those are the actual values by looking at the ASCII table. Okay, so in this case, RISC-V is using a little endian system, so reading these numerical or hexadecimal values is a little bit confusing. We're going from back to front, starting here, and we go in this order. So we go back to front reading, but we go front to back spell wise, and as well we go front to back value wise. So we're starting with 6e, n is the first value here, and then we go 20, which is the space, and then we go 3d, which should be the equal sign, and then we go 20 again, which is the space, and then we go to the next cell. But in the next cell, we start from the beginning, so we have a double zero, and that is here, it says 003, but in this case, the ASCII Z just uses a double zero as the end of string delimiter, I guess we would call it. So there's that, and then we have the spaces following in the next string. We start with, I think there's 7 spaces here, and we should see that there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I'm counting into 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. All right, so let's step through. First step, we are here at the LA instruction. And remember, the LA instruction is a pseudo instruction that is two separate instructions to load the address, which is 32 bits, into the correct spot. Unfortunately, this is only showing the address as the pointer to the data section, so we don't get to confirm that these addresses are actually true. As the code runs, we can assume they are. So we have the AUI PC, which is going to load the initial part, and I assume tell the PC to do, I'm not related to PC, but tell the CPU to do something to remember to add the rest of it, and we're adding the rest of the address, or whatever this is, to the same register, so some kind of concatenation, I'm assuming. All right, so we can begin stepping, and we can see that it's going through here. The A7 and the A0 correspond to the X17 and X10 respectively. We get to the E call here, and we hit it, and there you go. We have the string printed, the N equals printed, and we're ready to move on to the next instruction, which should be asking for input. Well, the next two instructions, which will eventually ask for input, and we can double check that. Boom, boom, and we didn't enter anything. So it skipped over, and we can see that the X26 value is equal to what was in the A0 value. It didn't throw an error or anything, it just passed along, as I was saying before. But it will throw an error if we throw in maybe a 0.7, hit enter, and there we go, we have an error. So there is some kind of error checking, I suppose. All right, so here we are. Let's enter in a valid value. Let's try 3. We'll hit the enter key, and then once we hit this again, we should see this value updated, and you can see that there is a 3 in there, and we can continue, and we should instantiate the other two variables, ones, and we see that, and then now we're in the loop, and we've already incremented once. We're going to keep incrementing the n value and the s value. We're going to keep going. I'm sorry, not the n value, the I value is what we're calling it, and we're going to keep going until it's equal. And then now we should start printing. And let's print the string s equals, and we did with a bunch of spaces. And then now let's print the n value, I'm sorry, the s value, which should equal the n value. And there we go. They do equal, so we have stepped through properly. And we can see that none of the values in the data changed because we didn't update anything in memory. The text values should also act similarly. And we can continue stepping through and now print a new line. And we're going to start back up at the beginning. Let's see how the n equals looks. And there we go. So we stepped through, we ran the loop, printed a new line. We started back up at the beginning. Now we're ready to go again. All right, so let's run through again. Let's not put a breakpoint at the branch not equal spot. All right. So now we're going to stop at the end of the loop and keep track of the values. Let's try n equals 5 this time. All right, so now we're at the breakpoint here, and we have our variables. The n is at the x26 location. The s is at the x27 location, and the I is at the x28 location. S started at 0, so s plus I, and I started at 1, so s plus I should equal 1, and I plus 1 should equal 2. But we should expect s to get bigger. So let's do loop number 2, and oh, now they're equal, because we had 1 plus 2, and then 2 plus 1. But the n value stays the same. The address of the variables, you can see here, this top row, these do not change. And you have these values in parentheses, and the actual address of this block is the value, is the address plus the value. Pretty simple. So that's loop 2. Now let's see loop 3. Okay, s is 6, 3 plus 3, and I is 4, 3 plus 1. That makes sense. Loop 4, s is a, and a is 9 plus 1, which is 10, and that's 6 plus 4, so that makes sense. And I is 5, that is 4 plus 1, so that also makes sense. And now the loop should break out, and we should be done with this loop, because I is equal to n. And you'd see that. We broke out of the loop, it finished programming, no other outputs were given except for the s, and you can see that the s was printed, s equals 10, a new line was printed, and we started back up at the top. Put in another value if we want, maybe 69, and we can cancel the breakpoint, and we can hit enter, and there we go. It didn't register that we canceled the breakpoint, so we are going to have to hit that a bunch, but we did, and it did register it. Now we get s equals 2 3 2 thousands 3 hundreds 4 tens and 6 1. So that's pretty fun. The s seems to increase much faster than the I ever will, and that's basically it. The address is here with the string values in the data section, and the values of the registers or the variables are in here, and the code itself is in the execute section. So that's all for this video, folks. I hope you found use to it, and if you have any questions, put them in the comments. I'm sorry that the neural network and the large language model knowledge has been lacking lately. I'm swamped with school, man. But we will get through it, and I hope you guys have a blessed day. It is Sunday, so please enjoy it, and thank you. Peace.